A conjoint reading of the aforesaid two clauses leaves no room of doubt that the administrative committee of the Gram Panchayat has been entrusted with the task preparing the merit of the candidates applying for appointment as Gram Rozgar Sevak to be appointed on a contractual basis. The select list has to be prepared on the basis of the marks obtained by the candidates in the descending order. The candidate obtaining highest marks has to be offered appointment for engagement from the list of the selected candidates, and the name of the selected candidate has to be forwarded seeking approval for the same from the Gram Panchayat. In the event the candidate obtaining highest marks shows his or her unwillingness to join the post, then the next candidate has to be offered appointment. In the instant case, this procedure of obtaining the approval of Gram Panchayat and joining of the selected candidate Kumari Julie took almost 2 years. Kumari Julie, the selected candidate at serial number 1, was admittedly employed in a madrasa institution from where she was also being paid an honorarium. Accordingly, she showed her unwillingness to join and ultimately dispatched a letter informing the Gram Panchayat to the said effect. Land Council for the appellant submits that this unwillingness and refusal to join the post was a clear inability of the candidate at serial number 1 for engagement due to her engagement in some other employment. Thus, this unwillingness cannot be termed to be an ineligibility of the candidate, and in such circumstances, no fresh selections were required to be held and the offer had to be made to the applicant who was at serial number 2 of the select list. For this, Sri Verma has submitted that if it was a case of ineligibility, then the option of clause 6 was open for holding the selection, but in the instant case there was no ineligibility on the candidate and rather it was her unwillingness to join the post which resulted in the vacancy, and as such the placement of the appellant serial number 2 could not have been ignored. The aforesaid argument of Sri Verma appears to be correct in as much as a conjoint reading of clauses 5 and 6 clearly establishes that it is in the event of unwillingness of the selected candidate that offer is to be made to the second in the list. It is only where the candidate is ineligible, when no option is left for either offering employment to any other candidate and the only option is left to hold a fresh selection. In the instant case, Kumari Julie, who was at serial number 1, did not accept the offer on account of her engagement elsewhere. This did not amount to any ineligibility on her part. Consequently, the offer could have been made to the applicant who was at the second place. However, what happened in the case? This took a span of almost 2 years, and even thereafter the writ petition was ultimately decided in November 2016, which was almost 6 years of the date of selection in the year 2010. The contractual engagement is for 1 year and extendable for another period of 2 years. In such a situation, we are not inclined to interfere with the impugned judgment or the order without approving of the reason contained in the order of the district magistrate dated 31 December 2013. Sri Verma submits that on account of the changed circumstances and the alteration of the status of the Gram Pradhan of the village, the appellant will be losing the opportunity to apply again for the said post in case fresh selections are held. In fact, the candidate to be engaged now has to be a person of the caste of the village Pradhan. This being a provision of law, the situation cannot be altered by us through a judicial intervention so as to extend any benefit to the appellant. In such a situation, even otherwise, the employment cannot be offered in contravention to the aforesaid policy of the government. The appeal, therefore, cannot be entertained. The same is accordingly dismissed.